Hello again. You're watching All Angles here on eNCA. So we take you straight here. Some consider him the most powerful man in the Free State. He holds the mantle of Secretary General of the ANC. Ace Magashule is loved and loathed alike. ENCA reporter Michael Appel sat down with one of his former allies turned foe.
Mr. Dukwana, thank you for giving ENCA some of your time. I'd like to start back in the day when you were considered an ally of then-Premier Ace Magashule. What was the tipping point for you when you became part of the so-called regime change bloc?
It's actually the realization that we were not dealing with an honest person. And we were dealing with a person who was self-serving, who actually hoarded power and understood power to be only useful when it is with him, instead of using a distributed power to make sure that you engage every person. He wanted more power, and we were now helping him. And that is when I felt that, and many of my comrades in the Free State felt that it was enough. We would no longer support him.
Some may say your criticism of Magashule stems from you contesting the position of Free State Provincial Chairperson. You never actually lost that battle, and you didn't contest, but are you perhaps bitter because of that?
Many people have contested before and still continued working together. And this was not a matter of life and death. It was actually to say we need also to have a change in the province, and we contested that. And unfortunately, when we realized that the processes were flawed, and we raised the matter with the highest office in the ANC, the then president of the ANC, and that is Jacob Zuma, who made an undertaking that he would follow up the matter, he would deal with the matter, and he understood what we were saying, accepted that. But we then realized that we were not dealing with people who were honest.
We must never allow a situation where we are defocused by a simple allegation that cannot be tested.
You were a provincial treasurer in the province. You know where the money was coming from and who it was going to. How was the Free State being run under Mr. Magashule?
I knew a lot in terms of raising funds, but we made it a point that we will not raise funds from people that were, the background were shoddy. There is no person, no municipality, no department who can say that I went to them to ask them to support a particular or force them to do anything untoward. And I never became a mouthpiece of any company in order for them to give us business.
The economic chances of emerging black business people, for instance, were completely decimated because the Magashule lot captured those opportunities and channeled it to their own people.
What we should never do, comrades, is to listen to what the media say about us.
In 2011, you said you went to the Gupta Saxonwold mansion with Mr. Magashule. They wanted you to sign a multi-million rand property deal for which you would get 2 million rand a month for 10 years. You would have been sitting on a nice little nest egg. Why did you turn that offer down?
It doesn't help for any person to get this, and while your soul is sold. And it became clear that all that they wanted was for me to do a wrong thing. What actually was worrying was the wording of the letter was actually stating that they should take everything as project managers, and it was taking the whole project away from government, and they were going to dictate terms. But we were worried that they would bring people from India and all those things. So
similar to what happened on the Estina dairy.
Yes. So I did not have that at the time. But also, when you get 2 million, where do you put it? You get 2 million, you get 2 million every month, but you become somebody else's tool. When I got a call from Tony to meet with him, and so it was, you know, that thing in you. So I said, let me go. I want to see, I want to hear what the man had to say. And really I went, and when we had the discussion, but it was like a person who was trying to say to you, it was a person who was gloating. In fact, he was trying to put in my face that you failed to take an opportunity. Look at you now, you are out. When they said, take this 10,000 or so, and then all that. So I took it, and people were saying, well, how can you do this? I said, I did that because it was not attached to anything. I traveled, and I found myself, it was useless, a trip. It was a person who was just saying, you know, you left 2 million, take 10,000 for your petrol, and that's it. They were so confident. They were running the show. They offered so much information during that time just to make me sigh. And it was one way of saying, we are connected. We can talk to the president anyhow. The president is just a phone call, because there was no need. They could have done that after I had left, but they decided to do that just to prove to me that they can do something. We can put that matter, we can deal with that. So I just felt that sometimes we put ourselves in a position that compromises us. And I felt that the president at the time was compromised in a relationship that I felt that it was not a relationship that has any respect for the president. It is. It has turned out to be a gangster state. It's a mafia. If you know, with the Don in control, you don't agree with the Don, you're out.